Is it possible for an attacker to bypass the endpoint detection response or the EDRs, and how we can detect that? So the answer is yes. Attackers can actually bypass endpoint detection response and get their malware to not be to not have any logs or any significant logs that you can see and you can actually react to through your SIEM or through your endpoint detection response dashboard. And the reason for that is there's multiple reasons. The first thing and the first issue that most of EDRs facing is that they do all of their control, all of their monitoring on all the applications running inside the user mode. And the user mode is where all the applications are running inside the actual memory of every application. And here's the thing. The malware has a full control over his own memory. He can see what's happening there. He can unhook the malware. He can unhook the EDR. He can actually cancel and remove this monitoring. And there's so many different techniques for the malware to actually get through the EDR to cancel all the EDR monitoring and get his activities running. And this is one type of bypasses, and there are many different ways, many different techniques to do exactly that, to remove the monitoring from the malware, to remove all the hooking and monitoring for all the different files opens or process injections or whatever the activities are. The malware can actually remove all the monitoring on all of these Windows functions or Windows commands and directly executing these commands without actually going to the EDR. So the EDR doesn't see anything and there's no logs for you to see and to actually take an action with. This is one way. And the other way is that the EDRs can't really go that deep inside and log everything that's happening in the system. Because if they are doing that, there will be millions and billions of logs from each endpoint. They will never be able to manage with all the volume of the activities is happening. So they do lots of filtering on all of these activities and only monitor and only log what's really, really important, what really represents an attack. Also, in your dashboard, there's so many events that's actually there. Even though they are filtering a lot, there is still lots of data that's being logged from each endpoint. And the SOC team only looking for the top 50% of log events, or the top 80%, or the top even 30%, whatever they are able to manage with. And they don't go much deeper than that. And because of that, the attackers actually use this to have lots of different ways, different other ways to achieve what they want to achieve. They go through using different techniques that does not being logged enough, being filtered out mostly by the EDR, or have a very low score when it's being actually logged. So example of that, they will not use this way of downloading the file, but they will use a bits transfer. They will not use the normal download or the normal APIs, but they use bits transfer. Or rather than inject inside a program and execute a thread there, so they do a process injection and actually executing the malware inside another legitimate application, which is something that is very high when it comes to alerts. They can go through and execute the code through a different channel, through a different way that's not being logged enough or is being used by so many other applications in a legitimate way. So rather than injecting a big chunk of data that looks like a malicious code, they inject in a very small pieces. Rather than use create remote thread, which is a known Windows command that attackers that the EDR is mostly sitting a high alert on it, they can use other techniques like set thread context or other ways to execute their data. So with that being said, there is so many ways to bypass. And the question comes, so how I can detect all of that? How I can detect this actually my endpoint has been bypassed and there is lots of things happening? Here's the thing. If you really want to have an effective incident response or effective threat hunting or effective detections, you need to get into the raw data. Whatever the tools you are using, they cannot log enough information that you can see in your SIEM or in your tools or in your dashboards. These products and whatever the next line of products that use AI or whatever, they will always hide so many events that's happening on the endpoint. Once you see something that is suspicious, don't go into analyzing more logs. Yeah, that's a good triage phase, but the most important is to dive deeper into the raw data. If you want to carry on a threat hunting assessment, then go into the raw data. Take a memory dump, investigate the memory, even execute some code by PowerShell that collects lots of information, use Kanza platform that collects lots of volatile and non-volatile information, and analyze this information. You can take mini dumps of different processes and analyze this memory, see if there's anything suspicious is happening. There's suspicious threads, there's code is being executed not in the right place, or not inside the actual pro application data. There is a memory allocated that looks suspicious. There are different suspicious strings or suspicious things happening inside the memory. The ADR is being unhooked or being removed out of this process, and so on. You need to dive deeper into the actual memory, seeing what's happening. You can do that by memory forensics, as we said, or through using some of the incident response frameworks like Kanza, for example, to collect information, take memory dumps for different processes, and analyze them yourself. Hope that video is useful, and see you in the next video. Bye bye.